Morning, Shirley.
Morning, Eli.
Morning, Phil.
What's wrong? Do it, Phil?
Shirley?
Eli.
Why I got to be the one? Tell him.
Tell me what?
Liz was here.
Ed, I didn't, hi.
Hi. I'm good. Yeah, no, I'm good. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing fine.
Good.
Looks like things are going well here.
No, no complaints. It's good. It's good. I'm engaged.
Oh, wow. Congratulations.
It's Carol. Vessi. It's Carol Vessi. I think you met her last time.
Oh, blonde?
Yeah.
Pretty?
Yeah. Pretty blonde. That's the one.
That's great.
So what brings you to Stuckeyville?
I have a proposition for you. A business proposition. Part of my consulting job has taken me into investments, and I have an opportunity for you.
Must be a heck of an opportunity. You're here in person.
It is. Great. But costly.
How costly?
$15,000.
Tater tots at 9:30 in the morning. Are you insane?
You know how they say you never appreciate what you got until it's gone? So true. This cafeteria makes the world's best tater tots. I gotta get some of these to Ed.
What if I told you that I could get you all the cafeteria tater tots that you would want?
I would say, what do I gotta do, my principally friend?
And then I would say, please teach my adult education class. My regular teacher, he got some kind of, I don't know, Japanese super flu.
Adult Ed?
Yeah, it's an evening class. It's creative writing. It's perfect for you.
Creative writing? It sounds sort of... I think about it.
Ooh, look at me. I'm Carol Vessi, big-time writer. I'll have my people call your people.
I wouldn't say anything close to that.
Okay, I'm just trying to pummel you with guilt so you can help me.
I'll do it. Fine, I will do it.
Yes! You are the best, okay? It starts tonight, and
you know what? We'll talk after I finish eating my tots.
It's a mall?
A small one, but I own it, along with some investors.
Hey, got yourself a good time golf with a Deputy Don, or Racing Jason, or Happy Gary.
Sheriff Gus.
Sheriff Gus, that's the one.
Here's the deal. They haven't moved in yet, but I have here a letter of intent and some signed contracts. And once they move in, the value of the property will likely double.
Well, good for you. And?
And they won't move in until the property's 100% ready, and it's taking longer than it's supposed to. They're threatening to pull out.
So you need investors, and you thought of me.
Look, Ed, most of my family and a couple of my friends have put a lot of money in this. If I take a bath, they take a bath. I just need a little more time, you know?
So this investment is really a favor?
It's an opportunity, and I think it's a good one.
Sounds to me like it's a favor.
Well, I really...
Favor, isn't it? It's a favor.
If you want it to be a favor, it's a favor.
Call it a favor.
You want to do it or not?
Sorry, Liz, I can't.
Hey! Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know you were in... Liz! Liz, it's Liz, isn't it?
Carol, congratulations. Goodbye, Ed.
It's crazy.
Yes. Baby, yes. Keep them coming.
Eli, can we talk about something?
Yeah, what's up?
Well, I was just wondering, we've been seeing each other a while now.
And you want to know when we're going to do it? Come on, don't be ashamed. You can ask me.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, and you want to know how a dude in a wheelchair going to be able to make you scream and holler like a damn werewolf, right? All right, tell you what, you can ask me anything about anything. It's no problem, even about the mechanics or how good it's going to feel, et cetera, et cetera. I tell you what, let's just get to the big question. You want to know how I still get my troops in formation, right? Answer, magic pill, baby. It shouts the orders loud and clear. Line up, boys, because we're going to war.
Okay, well, have you, done it since the accident?
Nah. Haven't found the right gal. Let me ask you something, Miss Jennifer Young. Are you ready? Are you truly ready?
Yes, definitely, Eli.
Nah, I'm serious, man. I'm telling you. Because you're in for a world of crazy goodness like you never had before, girl. I'm talking about that goodness that'll shake your body and rattle your soul, child. Mm. Matter of fact, I don't even think you're ready to handle this whole way, girl. Because you kind of frack. You like a little petunia flower. You can't handle this.
Shut up.
I'm telling you that. You're not ready.
Shut up.
I'll put pressure on you. How you sleeping on it? Can you handle this?
Shut up.
Hi, Liz.
Carol. Hi. Could I buy you a drink?
I would love a coffee.
Coffee,
thanks.
Well, this is weird.
Very. So, what's going on? What brings you to a little tiny town of Stuckeyville? Super skirt, that's cute.
Thank you. Business, actually. I'm starting my own. Looking for investors. I thought of Ed.
Mm-hmm. What kind of stuff are you doing?
I bought a mall. Good Time Gulch is the franchise is coming in.
Wow. Good Time. Come on in and say howdy to the Good Times, right?
That's the one.
Now, that's great. That's great. Congratulations.
Yeah. Yeah. That's not great. Could have been.
Well, what happened?
Long story short, I don't know if it's gonna happen. That's why I came to Ed. I need an investor.
He wasn't interested?
Right. It's not so bad, really, except for that my family put a lot of their money on the line, so. I'm sorry. Carol, I'm just babbling on and on. I'll figure something out.
Could I have another one?
Thanks.
Hi. Have a seat. Come on in. Hi. Welcome.
Carol.
Toby, how are you?
I'm good. I got satellite radio, so that's pretty sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Are you the new teacher?
I am. I had no idea you were interested in writing.
Yeah, well, after going over the books all day, I feel like I owe the right side of my brain a workout. Mm-hmm. Right side controls creativity.
I knew that. You did. So what kind of writing are you doing?
Well, my first love's poetry.
That's very nice.
Ah, it's a beautiful ring you got there.
Thank you.
Almost looks like an engagement ring.
It is. I got engaged last year, Thanksgiving, to be exact.
Huh. It's the lucky guy.
Ed Stevens, do you know him?
Yeah, I've seen him around. He's some hotshot legal eagle.
Well, yeah, he's a lawyer. He also owns...
Sit down.
Oh, let's get started. Hey. I've been thinking about this whole Liz thing, and I really hope that you didn't say no because of me.
Is it you?
Yeah.
You
because she's the ex. I'm your fiancé.
I didn't say no because of you. I said no because I don't want to help her.
Why not?
Why not? Well, for a whole host of reasons. Not the least of which is $15,000. We have a wedding coming up. We have a honeymoon coming. I don't want to help her. You think I should help her?
Yeah, sort of. Kind of. I do. But she doesn't have anybody else to turn to.
She can always try the mailman. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I'm sorry, Ed. Is that too much to ask? You know, I'm sorry, Ed. I'm sorry I slept with the mailman.
You know, she's in a really tough spot right now. She doesn't have anybody else to turn to. She stands to really hurt her family, her friends. It's
How do you know that?
Because she told...
She what?
I ran into her at the goat.
You... No. Did she ask you to talk to me?
No. I am meddling 100% of my own accord.
I don't know, Carol. I don't know.
Do me a favor.
Yeah?
Just... think about it.
Yeah.
Thanks, Ed. You saved the day.
I saved the day.
I was gonna say saved my life, but I think that was a little overblown.
Somewhere between the day and your life.
Yep, that's what you saved. Mm. Along with my hide, my parents' house, and my ability to hold my head up at future family gatherings.
It's a lot of saving.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, got some coffee?
Oh, hi, Toby. Yeah, getting some coffee?
Tea. Coffee doesn't agree with me.
Oh. Do you have something for class today?
Carol, what are we doing here?
Excuse me?
You're marrying this Ed guy? What are you thinking? Break the chain, lady. Break the chain.
Toby, what chain?
Carol, for years I've sat in my office, crunching numbers for the school, making sure everything adds up, but there's always one equation that never makes sense.
Toby, did you rehearse this?
No. Can I finish, please?
Go ahead.
But there's always one equation that never makes sense. Nick Stanton, Dennis Martino, Ed Stevens. Come on, Carol, don't you see a pattern here?
No.
You keep going out with these self-centered idiots who treat you like dirt. Writers, lawyers, principals. Sure, they live fast. They're dangerous. This Ed comes off like some sort of a race car driver. But he's not what you need. Carol Vesey needs a guy who will give her the love and support that a jewel like her deserves. You know where that guy is? He's right there.
Toby, I think that you are a sweet, wonderful man. But I already found the guy you just described, and it's Ed. I'll see you at class tonight, okay? It's over, Ed. All done.
What? All done.
You can have your money back, Ed. Good Time Gulch said they're pulling out.
I thought you were getting an extension.
Apparently not.
What reason did they give?
The restaurant's not ready. I haven't installed the booths and the tables. But they're a month late in shipping the booths and the tables, so it's like a catch 22.
Well, that doesn't make a lot of sense. If they're responsible for the delay, shouldn't they give you more time?
You'd think so, and apparently it's some other division.
Let me see the contracts. So what the folks at Good Time Gulch don't know is Liz knows a lawyer.
How's it going? Hi, Liz, I didn't see you there.
Liz ran into a problem with her deal. I'm just checking over the contracts.
I was wondering if you wanted to grab a bite to eat before I've got to teach my class tonight. It looks like you're busy, though, so I could just see you back at the house.
I'm sorry, Carol.
Oh, it's no problem, Liz.
See you back in the house.
You all ready?
Oh, yeah. Oh, hell yeah. That's the fastest I've ever done that. Lord, I thank you. I really do. I really do. I'd like to also thank Buddha, Jehovah, Confucius, Vishnu, Krishna, Allah, Sun, Moon, Earth, Barry White, Al Green, Teddy Pendergrass.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Carol.
Toby, what are you doing?
I'm doing what emergency medical technicians do. I'm saving your life. Sorry I missed class tonight.
What?
Carol, you can't marry this guy, this Ed. It'll destroy your life.
Toby, stop.
I can't stop. I can't let you do this to yourself. I'm trying to see if I can give this thing we've got CPR or some defibrillation. Clear!
Toby, we don't have a thing. We never had a thing. We went out on one date.
Two dates.
So? Toby, I'm sorry. I really am.
Let's go, Jerry. Tell the siren.
Can't. I just got a real call over on Swan Avenue. We're rolling.
Okay.
Toby, you can't be in here when I got a real call.
Oh. Sorry.
Does anyone go past Elm on their way home?
Bad news is, by the letter of the contracts, you're screwed.
Okay, but we're doing the whole good news, bad news thing, right?
Well, yeah, all right, well, good news. Letter of the contract is one thing, common sense. Another, you know, if it were me, I'd go over the heads of whatever business affairs bozo it is you're dealing with. You know, those guys have no power except to thanks enforce the actual contract itself.
So I talked to whom?
You got your own.
I'm sorry.
Well, if it were me, I'll go to the top, talk to the man himself.
Sheriff Gush?
Yeah.
And he's kind of creepy. He does a whole Yosemite Sam kind of, you know.
I know, but, well, it's his company. You know, he's all about being the family fun guy. You know, I'm Gus, the family fun guy. Hey, whoa, Ed's, Liz's, you know. Well, for me, I'd talk to Gus.
So I'd talk to Gus.
No, talk to Gus.
Gus is in New York.
Well, I guess you're off to New York.
I don't want to talk to Gus alone, Ed. Will you come with me? Please.
Yeah. Damn, girl, you almost killed me.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah. That was attempted murder.
So, did you enjoy?
Enjoyed? Come on, baby.
No, I know. I mean, did you feel it?
Boo, come on. I just made love to the most beautiful woman I've ever laid eyes on. Come on, you crazy?
Talk to me, Eli.
What are you asking me?
I'm asking if you could feel it.
No.
Carol? Honey, you home?
Hey! There you are. You had a late night.
How was class?
Well, Toby Gibbons is in my class.
Oh, yeah, he's smooth.
How did everything go with Liz?
Well, it's good, actually. Yeah, fine. But, I mean, there's a plan. I just have to implement it, which might be a problem.
What are you talking about?
Well, the plan's in New York, so to implement it, I gotta go to New York and have a face-off with Sheriff Gus, plead our case. I mean, Liz's case. You know Sheriff Gus, right? You know, the guy with the 10-gallon hat and the, howdy, I'm Sheriff Gus. You know, I'm Gruff Gus. Shoot him up. Yeah, you've seen the commercial, right?
You're going to New York?
Yeah, but just for one day, which is why I was thinking that
You're going to New York with Liz?
Yeah. Awkward, right? Her being the ex and all. But she's desperate, so what I thought was maybe you could come with us.
I can't do that. I've got a class to teach. I just started.
All right. No, I'm not going to go.
You should go.
I'm not going to go. I'm not going to go to New York.
No,
I'm not gonna go to New York with Liz without you, Carol. I'm just not. No, I'm not gonna. That doesn't make any sense. I'm not gonna.
Really? It's fine. Really?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. This is crazy. Let's go.
Well, slow down there, speed racer. He's got to show up sometime.
And that, Tommy, is how things work behind the scenes here at Good Time Gulch. Now, you keep your spurs clean and the sun at your back.
Bye, Sheriff Gus.
Bye now. Don't forget to have your parking validated. Howdy. Ma'am, what can I do you for?
Hi, I'm Ed Stevens. This is my client, Liz Brown.
Ms. Brown, I have been informed of your situation. Tough break all around. Sometimes you're on the saddle, sometimes you're under it.
Actually, Mr. Gustafson, feel free to break character. We're all adults here.
What if a tenderfoot gallops in here? Sees the sheriff acting like a
normal person?
I'd be deader than a tumbleweed.
As you wish. Listen, our situation here, really quite simple, sir.
I'm well aware of your situation, partner. I'm afraid it's not my problem if your client ain't quick on the draw. All due respect, ma'am.
Well, actually, it is your problem, sir, because your subsidiaries have yet to ship my client's fixture, so it's not Ms.
Slow down, cowpoke. Now, Ms. Brown, Mr. Stevens, business is business. Supply is supply, and demand is demand. You couldn't supply what I demanded, so I have to mosey on.
Wait a minute.
Don't forget to have your parking validated.
You all right, Eli?
100%.
Is that so? You gonna lie to me now? You know what? Let me go first. Last night wasn't what you expected, was it?
Yes and no.
Was it me? Was it something I could have done?
Nah, Obi, come on. Don't start thinking like that. After everything that happened, I knew old Eli wouldn't be able to throw it around like he used to. I knew it would take a special woman, that perfect woman to come along and have me open up like I did last night. That was you, Jennifer. I think I'm in love with you.
We don't have to do that, you know.
Have to do what?
What we did last night. I'm okay if we don't.
Why would you say something like that?
Because I think I'm falling in love with you too, Eli Cartwright Goggins III. And if it brings more pain than pleasure, I don't need it.
So you willing to give all that up for me? Oh. Jennifer Young, you're incredible, girl.
So you used to throw it around, huh?
Oh, please, girl. Ladies called me Captain Eli long before I had my seafood restaurant.
You crazy, you know that?
What an excellent ball, cried the old kindly Duke of Manchester. Pray tell, my lord, is not Lady Lucas the most enchanting creature you've ever beheld?
Very, very nice, Del. Would anybody else like to read to us? Anyone? Mr. Bremhorst? Toby?
Oh, me? Sure. I'd love to share.
Don't do anything you're gonna regret.
I'd like to do some poetry for all of you.
This is not your father's poetry. This is slam, the competitive art of performance poetry. This piece is entitled S-O-R-R-Y? Question mark. S-O-R-R-Y. Do I do the things I do? Ignorance, hate, stupidity, compassion, kindness, caring, envy, greed. Love? S-O-R-R-Y, do I do the things I do? S-O-R-R-Y, do I act the way I do? S-O-R-R-Y, do I feel the way I do? Why do I? Why? S-O-R-R-Y? I don't know, but I'm S-O-R-R-Y. Sorry. Thanks.
You know, that Sheriff Gus is an ass. He's supposed to be the world's nicest guy.
Weird.
Howdy, Parker.
Welcome the old apartment.
To family fun time. Oh, God, he's an ass.
Yeah, well, you know, I guess you don't get to build an empire like Good Time Gulch by being a nice guy.
Look at him. America sees its favorite restaurateur. You know what I see?
Go ahead, say it.
An ass.
That's what I thought you were going to say.
Good old Sheriff Gus is actually at... Whoa, incoming. What happened to the oil couch?
Oh, casualty of the great Cabernet spill of '02. It's in the great IKEA in the sky right now.
I see. Check this out. Good Time Gulch's acquisition for the last year, 11. Small properties. Just like yours, 16 the year before.
Is that weird?
Yeah, it's weird. What's Good Time Gulch doing spending all their time buying small properties they want to be tenants on, unless they don't intend to be tenants on these properties?
They signed the contracts.
But yeah, no, they signed your contract, but they'd do that if they knew they had a loophole to get out. Like, this whole thing's just a... I think it's just a scam, you know? It's just a process to wear you down and knock you out and make you bankrupt.
And they step in, pick up all the properties for next to nothing?
Yeah.
So the delay in shipping me my fixtures, that was... they did that on purpose, or...?
Yeah, well, that's the theory. Well, you still have the same painting.
I couldn't get rid of it. But unfortunately, I think you and I are the only two people on the whole planet Earth who liked it.
Liked it?
Loved it.
Well, I loved it more.
I paid for it.
That's true.
Okay, everybody, great job. See you next week.
So, Carol, you got a sec?
Sure, Toby.
Did you happen to hear the poem? I mean, I know you heard it, but did you hear it?
Yes, thank you.
I am sorry, Carol. I acted like a jerk.
You know what, Toby? Apology accepted.
Danke, Shane.
I had no idea that you did slam poetry.
Yeah, my college roommate turned me onto it. I got a lot of crazy thoughts bumping around in this noodle of mine. Comptrolling might buy the groceries, but slam feeds the soul.
So I'll see you next week?
Yeah. Carol, there's a poetry thing at the Goat tomorrow night, and I was wondering if you could come.
You performing?
Yeah, just workshopping some new stuff.
I don't really know that much about...
I could really use the support. Stage can be a lonely place.
I'll be there.
Great, thanks.
Okay.
It starts at 6, so if you get there at like 10 to 6, that'd be great.
Hey, what you doing?
I am just reading the writing of some of our town's most creative citizens. Do you know Jeff Donasek?
The dog catcher?
Uh-huh.
He writes way too much about shoes and feet. Hey, I'm gonna have a beer. You want one?
Yeah, please.
Is it Liz?
Yeah, listen, reason I'm calling, I'm not gonna be able to make it home tonight.
Uh-huh. What's up?
Well, found a way to make good on the deal, you know, and nail good old Good Time Gulch to the wall, but...
to do that, in order to do that, I can't come home tonight. I'm gonna have to stay till tomorrow.
Okay. Where are you gonna stay?
Where my Well, I don't know. Liz has a guest room.
Pizza's here.
Thanks.
You know,
I'll probably just stay in the hotel.
Don't be silly, honey. You should, you just stay at Liz's.
You sure?
Uh-huh.
Okay. All right, listen, I'll call you later.
Bye.
I hope you still love our sooch as much as I do.
The planet's so rotate around the sun. Here's to blowing apart Good Time Gulch.
Gus, you're going down.
I'd forgotten how many bad ideas you can come up with, Ed.
Bad idea, nothing. You'd be surprised how far you can go with confidence in a clipboard. A little dose of attitude, a little bit of loud talk, and you're in business, my friend. Watch this.
Hey! Excuse us. Over here. I'm looking for the foreman in this outfit.
You're looking at him.
You're the foreman?
Yeah.
Well, I would not want to be in your shoes, my friend. I just got an earful from the sheriff. Apparently, we're missing an order. Big order. Lots of stuff. Fixtures, seat covers, you name it. We're missing it. I got to find it.
Gus sent you?
Yeah, Gus sent me. Gus sent me.
What did he say exactly?
What'd he say? Yeah. You want to know what he said? I'll tell him what he said. I'll tell you what he said. He said when he finished yelling, he said, we better find that order for him or some greenhorn's going to get himself took behind a woodshed.
It sounds like Gus.
Exactly. Now, listen, I don't know what it means. I can tell you something. If I'm getting took behind a woodshed, I ain't going alone. You hear me, Dylan?
Here it is.
That's it. Gus will be so happy.
And why does it say hold on it?
They must want us to hold it.
That's good. I can see why you're the foreman. I'm gonna need a copy of this, Dylan. Thank you. Confidence in the clipboard, my friend.
Thank you, Eddie.
You're welcome.
So, how did it go?
Ah, good, fruitful, bountiful. You know, I think we made some headway.
Oh, good.
Yeah, good. I'm starving.
Oh, what happened?
Oh, well, we made a trip out there to the warehouse, and Liz, they had our holdings out there for about 3 weeks. You believe that?
Wow.
I know, sneaky rascals.
Honey, are you ready to go?
Yeah, I told Liz we'd be there at 6 o'clock.
Liz.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Yeah, she asked what we were doing tonight, and I kind of sort of invited her. That's all right, isn't it?
Of course.
Yeah.
What's Liz doing here?
Well, poor Sheriff Gus is putting an appearance at the Jasper Time Good Time Gulch. We thought we'd get in there and head him off at the pass, you know, home field advantage and all that.
Yeah, home field advantage is good to have that.
Let's go!
I'd like to perform a dirty limerick for you all. I've edited out the dirty part. There once was a man from Nantucket whose bleep was so bleep, 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 bleep. He said with a grin, bleep, 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 bleep. If my bleep were a bleep, 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 bleep. Thank you.
Totally, absolutely beautiful, everybody. Up next, we have Toby Gibbons performing some original slam poetry. Toby. Bang! 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 7 shots in the Philadelphia night.
Can I start over? Is that okay? Thanks, because... He's got a $5 haircut and a $2 smile. If he were a TV channel, I'd ask, can somebody please change the dial? Tall, dark, and handsome. More like gangly. Not dark. And a bum. I own a bowling alley. I'm a lawyer. I'm a bowling alley lawyer. I'm just so darn cute and perky and eccentric and fun. Hooray for me, I'm a jerk. Who cares? And what's with the grin? Hey, newsflash, Jack Nicholson got the part, Joker. How can you get hitched to tall, ugly, and slim? Come to your senses, girl. Don't marry him.
Boo. Well, what's that you're wearing? It smells good.
Steam of microwave popcorn.
Jennifer has juice. You know what you are, Jennifer?
What?
You are a lady with popcorn in your hair.
Oh, that's how it's gonna be, huh?
Ooh, in the face. You know what? Now I got to cut you. You know what?
What? Where you going?
To the bedroom.
No, wait. I thought we talked about that.
Yes, we did.
And I said we don't need to do that.
Yeah, but the thing is, I think we do.
Do you believe anything I say?
All right, before you go from 0 to 90, I believe you believe what you're saying for right now. But the thing is, Jennifer, you're a woman, and eventually you're gonna need something more. But I just don't want you going somewhere else to look for it. I gotta hold on to you, girl.
Eli, I can't say this situation is anything I'm used to. And I can't say things aren't difficult, but I can say this. I'm not going anywhere.
Well, listen, it's not about you going anywhere. I want to be able to give the woman I love every and anything she needs.
I thought you just thought you loved me.
No. I know I love you.
I know it too. What about what you need?
Well, the thing about my needs, boo, is nothing's never going to be the same again. So I just got to learn how to hit other switches, that's all.
What do you mean?
Like, smell. Touch. Perfect example, the other night, you did something that almost had me ready to flip my pancakes, girl.
What was that?
And you was kissing me on my neck. Oh, my goodness.
Where?
Right here. Right there, yes.
How's that?
To the bedroom. Come on. Come on, baby. Let's go to the bedroom.
How long is Liz staying here this time exactly?
How long is... until we're finished the Good Time Gulch business, I guess. Why?
No reason. I just, I think that people take advantage of nice guys.
Really? I think Liz is taking advantage of me.
No. I think that Liz came here because she knew you couldn't say no.
I did say no, Kyle. You told me to say yes.
I thought it would end with a check.
Why didn't you say something sooner?
I didn't want you to use me as an excuse.
Kyle, I know this whole thing's been tough on you, but I...
Honey, wait, listen. I know that part of you wanted to help Liz.
And part of me didn't want to help her, too. Look, I just... Liz came to me, and it was obvious she was in one place, you know, and I was in another place, a different place, a better place with you. And I just felt guilty. You know, so I said yes. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Carol?
Toby, hi.
So how are we doing? You behaving yourself?
Toby, what you did the other night was completely inappropriate.
I know.
But here's the rub. I needed to know.
You needed to know what?
If there was still anything between us.
Toby, haven't I made it abundantly clear that there absolutely is not, was not, and never will be anything between us?
Well, maybe. But you miss 100% of the shots you never take. That's the great one talking there.
The great one? Who's the great one?
Wayne Gretzky.
Sure.
Look, I took my shot, I missed. No regretskis, if you will.
Yes, that's correct. Sure, absolutely. Fine, we'll be in touch, thank you. You're golden. Sheriff Gus made his first rent payment. You are officially his landlord and will continue to be so for the next 10 years.
Oh. 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 How can I ever thank you, Ed?
Just your average everyday lawyer in, ma'am.
No, it's not. And after what, you know, everything, I really owe you, Ed.
No, you don't.
I do have a way of making a mess of things, don't I?
Well, mess? There's no mess. We cleaned up pretty well over here.
That's not what I mean.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry for how we ended. I knew then that I'd screwed up, but I guess I'm just beginning to realize that losing you was probably the biggest mistake of my life.